looking, you know, just to set it up. Ali's about to come in for the podcast. We're looking to set up a bit of an effect, a bit of a vibe, you know. Just, we've got this big screen that we could use. So we're just going for, do we go for the mantali.co.uk? You know, challenging people, men, to be the best version of themselves, yeah? You got the apparel, you know, sleek, cool, you know, purpose-driven street style, yeah? And then we've got another option, and that's
Stitcher.
Exodus, winner of the O2 Media and Best Entertainment Program. Exodus, that's a good. That's actually a
should
good.
Be rolling that quote, I think, actually.
Should be
started, but
that's so.
There you are.
Who do we put on there?
You're on there, mate. You made it. Hugely popular mentality.
I've made it. So we can have that on alternating.
Go on the podcast page.
Yeah, well.
No, go on the top. It is just
connected.
Scroll down, keep going. There's just mentality. Podcast.
Yes! That's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
For 030, aren't we like a few ahead of those?
These are the select few, mate. These are my favourites.
That's a big hitter, that one.
Yeah.
Literally a fucking big hitter, with a big hitter. That was one of the hardest but most rewarding ones, I think, podcast.
Yeah, that was a really, really good conversation.
Richard McCann there, that was flipping on your edge, wasn't it? Emotional.
So these are my top ones, basically.
Mm-hmm.
My picks.
Josh Warrington.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah. Right. Come on then, Ali's in. Come on in, Ali, lad. You got yourself a coffee, mate?
Yeah, I'm glad you were fine. I've had a really good day.
I fucking love that.
Fair play, man.
Should we have one?
You're welcome. Sorry, I should have offered.
Yeah.
Well, don't worry.
Wait, how are you guys getting back?
I float around mediums. I walk, I flipping cycle, swim, you know.
How's the swimming going?
Shit.
Yeah, I know, but how's it in the river and that? Last time I saw you, were telling me.
I go in and just float around and walk me back, because that's all I can do. Swimming gives me headaches.
Really?
Yeah, it sets it off, doesn't it?
So it's good to get in and be cold and stuff.
Yeah.
Do the breathing before.
Do the breathing, bit of Wim Hof. You didn't Wim Hof before?
No.
We'll get you doing, that's what we're going to do, an intro podcast here. So, right, well, we'll get these lads in.
You must do some breath work, right? Is that a thing?
No, not really. When you're running hard,
yeah,
it makes you breathe. Your
body does it for you. Yeah.
I want to say, do you try and nose breathe? But it's like it's impossible, isn't it? Once you go in, you can't nose breathe.
I think, to be honest, when you're like going really hard, your body is doing all it can to get air in.
The
oxygen into your lungs isn't a limiting factor, I don't think.
Yeah. Just bang a beer, Charlie.
He's not going to be wasting mental energy consciously trying to.
This is Adam from the Evolve membership. I'll tell you a little bit about that, Ali. And this is Charlie.
Nice to meet you.
Two boys from the start.
You too, yeah.
Charlie's flipping walked. Where did you walk, Charlie? 200 miles or something?
Went right as coast to coast.
Oh, great. I've done that.
Have you?
Yeah.
Good walk.
I've done it twice, actually. Yeah.
Ooh, did you run it?
One time I ran a lot of it myself, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, on my own, and I walked quite a lot of it with my dad. How old are you?
19.
He raised money for Rob Burrow.
Oh, brilliant. How many days do you do it in?
10.
Oh, great. Camp or stay in bed and breakfast?
I did 5 camps and 4 B&Bs.
How much did you carry with you?
About 13, 14 kilograms.
It's a fair bit.
Good effort.
Make sure you can hear everyone's voice like at the same volume by putting the headphones on.
Oh, glass of red wine on him, like Joe Rogan next,
My first thought was that it's going to be some high cordial sports drink or something. It's a red wine.
7 o'clock on a Wednesday night now. Not like some weird, I just had a really long day and I thought I went to the. Nice. I was trying to get milk and he was like, come to the bar to get milk. I was like, alright. And then I was like, oh, do I should buy some glass of wine?
This is what I looked for. I ended up with a coffee because there was no milk.
Yeah.
And I pressed the machine. Thinking,
Alright, the Snipers Creed 2 would come on, and then hot chocolate came out, and I despise hot chocolate, so I had to tip that down the toilet, and I thought, right, I'll get hot water. And then there was no milk. I was like, shit. So now it's going to have to be a coffee.
So sure, you have you had a coffee?
I've came with coffee, yeah. So
you want to have a fucking hell, is up at? What time are you up at?
I get up at 3:30.
Really? What for? What do you do?
Just work. Oh. Nothing special, just a delivery driver.
That's brutal. Every day?
Yeah. 7 days a week, but finishing soon. 4 weeks left, and then
oh, wow.
Get my life back. I can train again in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that is brutal.
You did a few marathons, didn't you? And fucking
I've done two marathons in 3 hours, yeah. This is what I want to get back into. This is why I'm here to sort of pick your brains about it.
Oh, so cool, yeah.
What better inspiration.
Back in. Exactly. This is what we're saying outside. Like, you get a chance to sit in a room with yourself, and then there's five of us here.
If it's working, can you see us? Can you see me?
You are. Like, your hand is in it.
They don't want to see me.
Okay, you can just move up closer to Chris. We have to snuggle in a bit more.
That's
well. Are we on?
We're starting. When we're starting.
Yeah, do you want to start now?
Yeah.
Just got that behind you. Got Chris's website for you.
Ah, that's no need to do that.
That's, if you need anything writing, Ali, you know, if you need any players doing, well, here's your map. Here's your map. Right. Easy. Cheers.
Thanks very much. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, man. Cheers. Super you. Interesting. Yeah.
Special podcast there with our ball guests.
Class, yeah. Thank you.
No, thank you. Thanks for coming.
Hey, can I ask for something? Can you have a proper like introduction so we can put it at the beginning of the podcast?
Yeah, we'll do it after. Yeah.
We'll do it when Ali needs to get to bed.
He's
had 14 red wines.
If only. That would be a more interesting podcast.
That would be part two.
Maybe that should be a podcast. I know, like... Yeah, whatever.
Like after hours.
Well, like, you know, all these like fancy guys smoking weed or whatever they do in America, you could just like give people pints of Tetleys or
pints
something.
Pints of bitter.
Guffbo's got a new beer out on his local lager. You have to fucking knock them back.
You know, you said you've been to all these parties as well, and you've been drinking all the, you know, red wines and stuff like that. Who's the most famous person that you've had a drink with?
I didn't go to that many parties and drink that much, but after the Olympics, you do get invited to some cool things. Who is the most famous person?
You know, like,
apart from Stevie.
Yeah. You know, almost like an icon.
I've had a few drinks with him.
Yeah.
I'll let fucking hell go drink.
Oh, no, it's definitely Stevie Ward again.
You know, all the countries that you've been to, you know, even sort of like athletes aside, you know, is there anyone that sort of like stands out as if to say, you know, have you ever been in that position where you've been like, lost words and like, wow, you know,
I've never been lost for words. I don't think I've always tried to be like really respectful. I've been a mayor, I've been super lucky over time, you know, met politicians, prime ministers, the Queen, other members, royal family, etc. Athletes and stuff. I think there's like meeting people like that. I think one thing I was really conscious of the book is that I was asking like for people's time, and people like, you know, Ronnie, obviously he gets so much, you can only imagine the amount of requests he gets on his time.
I'm a massive Snooker fan as well.
Obviously, Ronnie, we are still waiting on that email.
And Kimmy and Jordan and various other people, and for those guys to give me the time. And if you read the book, I'm not plugging, but if you do, Ronnie, I actually met him at his mum's house where she made us dinner, and we sat down and chatted over a plate of lasagna, and that was really cool. Yeah. You know, because ultimately he'd gone out of his way and made the time and sorted it out, and we just had a great chat. So I think that's probably the most.
Did you record it, or did you just think, oh, I'm going to get the sense of it, or did you make that?
No, I recorded it, yeah. I found interviewing quite a challenge, like thinking, having questions, thinking about the responses, trying to think about the next question. I found that quite hard, actually.
Yeah, and then the order always changes. Mm-hmm. And like, the way you think it's going to go, they'll have answered two of your questions in the first part sometimes and stuff, yeah.
I just found it interesting because, like, an inversion of me asking you that question was like, for example, me joining this Evolve program. Like, firstly, you know, meeting Stevie, it's like, you know, before you meet someone like that, he's just the guy you've seen off TV, or, you know, you're the guy that you've seen on TV. And then to be presented with an opportunity like this to sort of sit down in a room, it's like, you know, I was saying to you outside, it's like, you've got this opportunity. My girlfriend was saying tonight, you know, where are you going? I'm like, I'm going to sit down in Olympia. And she's, you know, it's like, right. But to get that opportunity, and, you know, it's like, it's not something that I'll forget.
You chose to take it as well.
Like, but yeah, that's what I mean. It's like, as I say, I've been beating this drum about the environment that I put myself in, and, you know, things that can affect other things. And it's like, if this is, you know, like Stevie presented it, you know, there it is. What do I need to do to take it? And, like, you know, if it is, I don't care what time I get up, it's like, if that's there, then I'm going to take it. But, you know, the question to you was, have you found yourself inadvertently in positions where you're like, you know, you've got to sort of pinch yourself, like, you know, almost like I've done tonight?
Yeah, well, yeah, I think not,
guys.
For me, not so much with people standing on an Olympic podium, like, stood there thinking, how the hell did I get here? Yeah, so yeah, for sure, I've found myself in positions that that I didn't think I'd ever get myself into, for sure.
Yeah, as I say, I find this stuff interesting.
Mm-hmm. Same, and I always feel it's not every day you get to speak to the greatest athlete of all time. So it's a privilege and
it's class, isn't it?
Yeah,
fucking. Really, I love podcasts. I just think it's
sort of random.
Just
if you got on next.
We've
got quite a few backed up.
We've got some fucking funky ones, haven't we?
Just tell your back up so you can just release them free.
Steve Peters. We've done one with Professor Steve Peters. Yeah, I don't know if you, because he did with some TGV, didn't he?
Yeah, I don't know him personally, but I've read some of his books and stuff.
That one might be out tonight, that.
Because I was listening, which is what you were saying about, you know, having that voice in your head, it's almost like the chimp, and arguing against the chimp. Yeah. And I, you know, when you were talking about it, I was like,
Did you do that on live? Is that on live?
That was on Zoom, that live.
I think I did that.
Yeah. I was thinking, you know, what you were saying about conflicts and, you know, all this and all that. It's like, what point do you get to where you're like, right, this is the chimp? And then Steve was saying about, if you try and fight the chimp, you know, you're going to die 5 times quicker.
What you resist, persist.
Yeah, that's it.
It's a big thing.
And then, you know, again, what you were saying about flowing, it's like, right, the opportunity's there, let's go for it. And then instead of seeing the finish line, just take it.
Instead of fighting, going, oh, fucking hell, I should be thinking like this.
As it presents itself,
you know, just accept it, and then by the time you're in it, you're in it, aren't you?
Yeah.
In comp.
It literally finished as I pulled up in the car park, it was a good hour and 4 minutes or something, I think.
I did a good one recently with these psychedelic scientists.
That was a business.
It's just really interesting. Like, people.
I like psychedelic drugs.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're like from a completely clinical, not from a, like, they were just coming at it from a.
Not like a post Olympic fucking mashup.
I know, it's really fascinating. That's the research.
Using it for depression, using it for.
PTSD with soldiers and things like that, and yeah.
What were they? What were the drugs?
Magic mushrooms?
Yeah, the active ingredient in magic mushrooms. Dimethyltryptamine, DMT, which is that, I think it's ayahuasca.
Yeah,
there was
a YouTube
about
it.
You might go down a rabbit hole if you listen to that. Just, it's like, how do you explain it?
So if you Google the James English ayahuasca documentary, it goes out to, like,
Does he do it?
He's done one about 3 years ago, and he's taken it, and he was with all these shaman in this, like, retreat up in the mountains somewhere, and he explains, and he records it as well. It's like, interesting.
So they try and tackle that kind of perception of it, right? But no, obviously, it's the same ingredient, they have a lot of respect for that, but, like, I think that can put a lot of people off, but I find that stuff super interesting. Yeah. In a nutshell, Ali, the science behind that is that they think that we perceive the world through our sense perceptions, like touch, sound, but they've evolved to just get us through life, and that these drugs actually turn them off and you see the world as it really is. There's all these like consistent different people who have these all these weird experiences and see these same entities, and and they think and have this real sense of oneness with no ego or self. They think that's kind of much more like what the basic state of existence is.
So that's why you talk about meditation, to keep bumping you up
there. Yeah, to get closer to that state.
That the lad that I'm on, he was saying that he had a trip, I think he had psilocybin magic mushroom, and he literally, like, it took him through every interaction he'd ever had. Planet Day Dot, he was saying.
What, while he was having this trip?
Yeah. It took him through every interaction.
He was third person in it or something?
Third person watching it.
It, yeah.
And then, like, jeez. So
it's like flying the wall.
Yeah.
Did he say it was a good thing to?
He said obviously the like journey of it, but after he was filled with so much like compassion, like so much like empathy, like understanding of himself, understanding of why he was that way, understanding of why, you know, he did done certain stuff, and like it's like next level.
Wow.
Next level stuff.
I'll do that James English pod though. That sounds interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, is it a documentary, do you say?
Yeah, he's recorded it on
YouTube.
Yeah.
Might be us sat down in 100 years talking about. Hey, up, Ali, coming, so.
Smoking your pipes.
Yeah. How about that trip, mate? Yeah. That would be fucking good though, that.
Cool.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna get going anyway. Thank you.
Yeah, mate, thank you so much.
I don't know why I'm fucking bagging them, then, won't they? You need to fucking get running, you boy.
I'll have a wine. Thanks very much.